All right, let me tell you about Cook Unity. Cook Unity is a prepared meal kit where all you have to do is heat it up. That's right, you can either microwave it or put it in the oven, and you have chef-prepared meals in minutes. Southern fried chicken and spicy honey, pepper deli with pork ragu, mission-style beef burritos, even beef tingo tacos. Or how about a grilled flank steak bowl? Chefs create different menus every week, and you can choose from your favorites. Cook Unity has it all, and I use it. I love it. Go to cookunity.com and pick your plan, and maybe give yourself a couple of nights off from cooking. It's less expensive than takeout, and Cook Unity delivers right to your door every week. Buy your groceries for all your other meals. Have dinner on Cook Unity. And right now, if you go to cookunity.com and use the promo code MOODKILLERS, get 60% off on your first order. Go now, cookunity.com, for people who actually love food.
Look, I made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greetings, Mood Killers. It's Eddie here with Marconi. Have you been abducted by aliens? I've never asked you this question.
I think maybe. I mean, I don't know.
You think maybe?
Well, you know,
like, I mean, a lot of people out there are saying they've been abducted by aliens because aliens are really popular now. And I don't believe I've ever asked you. I don't believe I have been abducted by aliens. When I was a kid, I really wanted to be abducted by aliens. I remember sleeping, like having sleepovers at childhood friends' houses.
Did you ever camp out in the yard?
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's like we would camp out and sleep on the trampoline with sleeping bags. And I would just lay there hoping that an alien would come grab me.
When you would camp out in the yard,
yeah.
Did you, like me, was there a long, was it an electrical plug-in cord and you had all the amenities that were inside your house?
Oh, yes.
But in the yard in a tent?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we used to set up a tent. If it weren't at one of the friends that had a trampoline, if they came to my house, but we'd set up a tent in the backyard. Yes, yeah. An electrical cord that would be plugged in, and then there'd be this. I had this little tiny crappy black and white TV.
Yeah,
and I'd bring that into the tent.
Absolutely. And,
yeah, we'd watch like Urkel or something. You know,
Urkel. You know what? Yeah. We're watching Urkel tonight. Can't we just watch it anytime? No, but we're watching Urkel outside, you guys.
Right, right. And then meanwhile, the rest of my family had it on in the living room.
Right. You know, it's the same thing, though, as like making a pillow fort. That's kind of like the thing now, I think, that's replaced camping out in the yard because people don't, like kids
people
don't camp
out in the yard anymore. That's ridiculous.
People, parents don't let kids have sleepovers anymore.
Why?
I don't think. I don't know. I think they're just worried that stuff happens. You know, they're worried that like a lot of things. But I don't. They don't let it.
Sure.
There's not a lot of that going on that I know of.
Sleepovers are done. That's I hate to hear that because I had so much fun with sleepovers.
Seriously, and the best part was like I would have them at my grandmother's and all my cousins, like 14 cousins. Would all just lay strewn about the house. And at some point, my grandma would crack. And she would, and she never yelled at me. I was her darling. Honestly, and my cousins kind of resented me because I was the chosen one. Because my father only had one child and he passed away early on. It was her first son that she lost. And I was his only offspring. So I became the chosen one. Because I had other uncles that passed away, but they had more than one kid. So I was like this special highlight. I don't know why. Probably because they knew, you know, I was just she knew I was a loser. And she gave me some extra attention. But my cousins didn't like it. Anyway, we would sleep over and it was great. My grandma would lose her mind after a while and something would get broken. Like somebody would throw a sock into the ceiling fan and it would like crack or something. And she'd be like,
good.
And I love this, and RIP Grandma Pearl, but she would say, there's no damn sense in it. And my cousins get together every year, and they have this memorial, like, reunion, and my grandma's picture is hoisted up, and underneath on the banner it says, there's no damn sense in it.
It's the greatest.
I love that.
I'm just that's too scared amazing. To go there because, I mean, they hated me then. Imagine how much that's boiled up over the years. So I stay away.
But they're going to throw you into the ceiling fan if you show up.
That's right. I'm next.
Yeah. Killers. Our favorite Taco Bell, they have this experimental menu that they have. What they do basically, let me back up a little bit. They invite social media influencers to the Taco Bell labs.
Mistake.
And then, Yeah. And then these influencers will go and then they'll talk about all of the crazy stuff that Taco Bell is working on. And I came across one on TikTok last night. And some of these items seem a little interesting to me. Let's see what you think of these. These are new Taco Bell menu items that are in the works. We may or may not see.
Taco Bell just did an Apple-like event for their new menu. It's amazing. Watch this.
A little twist on something that you guys love. Chicken and steak enchilada grilled cheese dipping taco.
Chicken and steak grilled cheese enchilada dipping taco.
First of all, I don't like the guy. I don't like that influencer energy of the guy telling you, hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, guys, oh, my gosh. Oh,
I'm so fatigued with that energy. Stop it.
I know. Usually I would not, play something like this on the show because of that energy. I hate it.
Yeah.
But these Taco Bell menu items just really fascinated me. Like this taco that they have, grilled cheese taco enchilada that you dip.
I like that. It sounds good.
Yeah.
I like dipping things. And the sauces at Taco Bell are delicious. So, yeah.
Oh, yes.
What about Dulce de Leche Cinnabon Delights?
De Leche Cinnabon Delights.
That guy could barely say it. There's nobody whiter than that guy trying to say these names.
You know what I mean? Our brand new Taco Bell hot sauce crackers. Mild, hot, fire, Diablo. And there's a newcomer to the bunch. We have a birthday in the house.
Oh my God.
So the
didn't it sound like he said there's a newcomer to the bun? That's all I heard.
Newcomer to the bun.
Yeah.
Oh, I love the air horns. Can we play one more time, please? Thank you. Baja.
He's
blast.
That guy that never had a microphone. They're like the first time they let him speak, and he's like, "Oh, I can command things. Like I can tell people to do the air horns again."
Right.
20 years old this year. 20.
I've never had that Baja Blast Mountain Dew. Have you ever had that?
I've never had a 20-year-old taco either. Is that what he's promoting? No.
I think
the Baja Blast is 20 years old. Is that serious?
Yeah, I thought it was new. Yeah, I mean, I never.
I'm always having a blast.
You're right.
Behold the Crunchwrap. When you look inside, that is a Cheez-It inside.
Yeah, so they have a Crunchwrap Supreme with a giant Cheez-It inside.
We didn't need that. Did we need that? Maybe we did. I don't know. I mean, I'd have to try. I mean, the thing is Taco Bell kind of knows what people like, and they're not messing around too much. Like, they experiment, but once they put something out in the universe, they pretty much know that it's delicious.
So, I mean, I really have to hand it to Taco Bell overall, though, because they actually innovate their menu. They're not like other places that have the same menu for years and years and years. They're creative.
Even if it's great and perfect the way it is, and somebody will say, if it ain't broke, But Taco Bell knows that, like, sales go up and down, and when you add new items, you get people coming in. Like those nacho fries. Are you kidding me? Every time they're available, I'm like, I got to go get something from Taco Bell. I love those fries.
Right.
You know?
And by the way, they didn't pay us for this segment at all, but they should. So I'm going to send them an invoice. Well, scientists always want to ruin everything because they apparently have to study everything, and it's really annoying,
What do you mean with facts? I hate when they bring facts. Can't we just choose?
Well,
I mean, don't some people now just choose not to believe facts? It's just like whatever they want to believe?
And I don't think you're not going to agree with the science. I'll tell you that much.
Okay.
Because scientists explain why so many people are obsessed with Taylor Swift.
Okay.
Do we need scientists to get involved in this?
No, they should be working on other things. Like, why the other week I almost passed out on the show. Like, what was going on? Too many bananas? It can't just be that.
A pill that makes it so you can eat 3 bananas and do mood killers.
And 4 lattes.
Day.
Come on. Yeah. What the hell?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, they say everyone loves Taylor Swift because of the more exposure effect. And this means that the more and more you see something, the more and more you love it.
I agree to a certain degree, but what she's done masterfully, and because she wanted to take back control of the masters of our music, she's been releasing music more frequently. And because of that, a music cycle, like an album cycle, has been sped up. And because of that, her popularity of her music, and then on top of that, the Eras tour where she's showcasing all of the different eras of her music, it's been pretty great. And the fact that you look at her her cycles of albums, and she does do more albums than most artists do, and now she's got, like, you know, like when you go see like a Paul McCartney and he's got these decades of hits after hit after hit with Wings and Beatles and all this stuff. Well, Taylor Swift's got the equivalent of that and way less time. And so when she does a massive concert, people are hearing hit after hit after hit. I mean, that Eras Tour concert it's a rare
3 hours of hits.
Yeah. I don't know many radio stations that could play 3 hours of any artist with just hit after hit after hit. There's not a lot of them out there. There's a few, but not a lot. And so,
how come a radio station out there hasn't done like a Taylor Swift weekend where they play nothing but Taylor Swift?
I think they have. And I think they've done it too, like when her concert is in town, that kind of stuff. But I would just do like, you know, like KUFO, the old station I used to be on, was Ménage à Trois weekends. I would just do a Taylor Swift weekend and play nothing but Taylor Swift nonstop. And if you hate it, then you don't listen. And if you love it, the issue is there's more people that love it than dislike it. So you win anyway.
Well, sort of like, and I thought it's interesting that the more exposure effect has, in my head, I thought it was going to be the opposite. The more that someone is around, the more likely society is to get sick of that person. But apparently that's not true. But it didn't work for The Rock. I'll tell you that much.
Well, for you anyway, like you're not a fan, but you know,
get that guy out of here.
You know, what's funny to me is because even as a huge Swiftie as I am, after the Super Bowl, and every outlet that I follow on Instagram had a post, a different angle, a post of Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce at the after parties. And it just kept coming up in my feed over and over, even on TikTok.
Did you get
and
tired
even
of
I was like, enough, you know, like I am happy for them. I'm glad they won the Super Bowl. Taylor Swift won her first Super Bowl. That's fantastic. Right. I hope she gets a ring, you know, all that stuff. But I was like, you know, that's I've seen this party for, you know, 2 days or 3 days or whatever. And I'm like, enough. I get it. And now what they will probably do is Taylor Allison Swift, as she does so eloquently, and she will go into hiding for a while and kind of just disappear, except for her concerts and stuff. And then in April, she'll have a new album come out and I'll start over again. So, She's always working, Eddie. That's the thing.
She's here forever.
That's right. She's not going anywhere. Eddie, whether you want to or not, you're about to learn something. It's, did you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Eddie, did you know only 8.4% of Americans don't wear seatbelts? But roughly 50 of those killed in car accidents were not buckled in. 50%. I hate a seatbelt.
Wait, what?
I hate when you get in the car and like it doesn't, you have to, if the foot's on the brake, you can't adjust it right. As you know, somebody's in a hurry to take off and you're trying to, and you're a passenger princess like I always am. And
the thing is with the newer cars is they beep incessantly until you buckle up and put the seatbelt on. And it's just really, even if I made the mistake of putting a bunch of heavy groceries on the passenger seat of my car and it would not stop beeping because it thought there was someone sitting there.
You don't buckle in your groceries? I mean, come on.
What I did is I reached over and I buckled in my groceries as I was speeding down the highway. So it kind of defeated the purpose of wearing my seatbelt. Like, what's the deal here?
Don't do that. Your precious cargo too.
I know. Well, why can't my car like tell that there's a ham on my seat and not a person? I don't like that.
A giant
40-pound
ham sitting
there. My weekly ham.
Yeah, that's right. You have to you carve it yourself with your own tools.
That's right.
At home.
Yeah.
Yeah, Eddie, here's another one. Did you know less than 1% of people in China are left-handed? And at least that's how many people admit it. I guess it's considered a biological flaw in China if you're left-handed. So
people force themselves to not be left-handed? Is that
or they just won't admit that they're left-handed, and they train themselves to, yeah, like they do things with their right hand just so they learn.
Maybe if they realize their baby's left-handed, they'll tie a hand or something weird.
My mom is ambidextrous, or she was when she was younger, and she trained herself to be right-handed. I think it's interesting what people do they think is wrong. I'm kind of that way too. Like, you know, I drink my coffee left-handed. How about you? And do you notice if you buy coffee with like a mug with a photo or a logo or something on it, it's always meant for a left hand?
I have noticed that. Yeah.
Yeah. Because when you're right-handed, you'll hold a cup left-handed so you can do things with your other hand.
Uh-huh.
So that logo
should be a whole other fact on here.
Did you know?
Yeah.
Okay.
Did you know there's a secret room hidden behind Lincoln's head on Mount Rushmore to store important documents? Now, I don't know what's in there, what the documents are, but that's a giant. See,
behind
those,
Lincoln's head.
Yeah, and those are terrifying if you go there at night. Wouldn't you think? Like, if you were there after hours, like you had been in, and you were inside Lincoln's nostril, that would be scary.
What? Why would they store documents behind Lincoln's head at Mount Rushmore? That's
I don't know.
Insane.
That seems weird.
They don't have a file cabinet there at the Pentagon they can use?
Yeah, there isn't a base. I mean, don't they have those basements everywhere all over Washington, D.C.? Maybe they, right. you know what it probably is? And I don't know why they would tell this then, if it's supposed to be special documents. But you know how, like, you're supposed to keep a copy of something in different locations? So if your house burns down, you still have it, you know, and it doesn't mean as much now because everything's on the cloud. But, you know, they want a physical document. So maybe that's part of the reasoning. I don't know.
It's probably a backup. Like, they have Meemaw's oatmeal cookie recipe there or something.
Yeah, that's right. That's what it is. It's a cookie recipe.
Good.
Eddie, did you know Houston, we have a problem isn't the exact quote when Jack Swigert was communicating from Apollo 13? He actually said, quote, "Okay, Houston, we've had a problem here." But everyone else heard, "Houston, we have a problem." And I mean,
you sure that's not the Mandela effect that they talk about? With is that what it is?
Yeah, yeah. Like,
Luke, I am your father.
Yeah.
What was that? It's not really Luke, I am your father, isn't it? It's something else.
I thought it was Luke, I am your father. Luke, I am your father. That seems right.
It's something else. It's
if only there was a magic box. You could Google.
I'm Googling it right now, actually.
What's the actual quote?
The actual quote is, I don't know why it's not coming up. My computer is locking up.
He slices off the hand, right? That's what happens first. He loses his hand and it falls down that shaft. And he's like, oh my God, that would be so traumatic. I wouldn't be able to focus on anything else. Yeah, I don't care what you're saying about being my dad. You just cut off my damn hand, dude. Like,
so
what
he
the
doesn't
hell?
Say, Luke, I am your father. He says, no, I am your father.
Oh, that's.
But that's not how everybody remembers it. Like, I remember it as Luke, I am your father.
And everyone that quotes it says that, you know, all the quote
but
guys.
He says, no,
Luke,
I am your father.
I am your father. Wow.
Yeah.
This is interesting. Did you know Schindler's List and the Vanilla Ice movie Cool as Ice had the same cinematographer, a guy named, Janusz Kaminski.
Kaminski, yep.
Janusz Kaminski, right? Okay.
I knew it.
He won Oscar for Best Cinematography twice for Schindler's List and then Saving Private Ryan. And then Cool as Ice was another one. What a weird.
Okay.
But I guess, you know, we've all had weird jobs, so I don't know.
No, yeah, and it just shows he's a versatile guy.
That's right. He can shoot great movies, very in depth, and then, you know, and, something with vanilla ice.
He can
ice.
Also, never mind. But no. Yes. No. I mean, I am not going to make a joke because of the, but that's cool. That's
Here's
cool.
another one, Eddie. Did you know Michigan?
Yeah.
Is 96,700 square miles, and 45.5% of that is water, the most of any state. And New Mexico is the
Talking
only
lakes.
Yeah, and New Mexico is the only has 0.24% water, which is the least of any state, which is terrifying to me. And that's you know, I lived in Tucson. I grew up in Tucson, Arizona. And I think I could never live in a desert again. I just think about, like, if something happened to that water flow, wherever they get their water from in those desert states, are you going to be able to drive fast enough to get to water?
Isn't this what they're always saying? This is going to happen to Las Vegas because they get their water from California, and then California doesn't even have enough water.
Right.
So like, oh, Vegas has 5 more years of water left, yet they keep building there. Right. I don't get it.
Yeah, like, you know, that's why you live in watery states, you know? In the Pacific Northwest, you just put a bucket on top of your house. You'll be fine.
Right.
You know, just like that. Yeah. That's what you do, right?
That's it. Yes. They're saying that granny panties are sexy again, and they're back in style. I don't know.
Were they ever sexy? I mean, I don't know. I used to, when I was younger. Now, listen, I'm more for comfort now, and I've evolved a lot as a man. And I know you two have also, Eddie. But there used to be a rule. Like, if I had a girlfriend, if a girl had granny panties, I would say, get out. It was over. I mean, jokingly, of course, I was lucky to have anyone even look at me, but I didn't like that granny panties. And now I realize, you know, it's a toxic thing to do, but I was, half joking really, but I didn't like them. But now I understand comfort is very important. As a person who lies around in my underwear most of the day, I really like comfort. And I can
That's
understand.
Why you wear granny panties, right? That's
right. I mean, my boxer brief, whatever these are. I mean, that's what I have.
And I totally get not wanting to wear a thong either, like, to have that expectation. Yeah. Like, it's just not cool to have that string up you all day. I mean, come on.
But, like, the only reason to wear a thong, I feel, if you're a woman, is if, like, you're wearing a dress that requires it. Other than that, and if it's a special occasion and you wanted to dress that way for your man, that's cool. Or whoever, your significant other, whatever. But I don't think it should be something that it's expected, ever, you know?
No, and actually the thong kind of overstayed its welcome a little bit because it was just getting to the point where you would see the back of the thong if somebody was wearing a certain cut of jean, and it started to look a little trashy, you know what I'm
saying? Wasn't that called, like, the whale tail back in the
right.
day? And then, I think it hit its peak with the thong song, you know?
The thong song, yeah.
With Cisco. Don't forget Cisco.
Cisco.
I don't know where he is now. I think he's probably producing music, but I really, I think, you know, when he did that song, I can't remember how that song went. I love it when the booty
thong,
go.
Song, song, song.
Yeah. I love it when the that booty, one, yeah. oh, I love it when the booty go, ha. It was a delightful soliloquy that he put together.
But, you know, if you like to wear the granny panties, though, I mean, like, that's the thing is, like, don't let anybody make you feel bad. Be
don't
comfortable.
Don't feel shamed. Yeah. Don't ever feel shamed. Men should never have. I guess the thing is if a man likes to look at a certain panty, let them wear it. You know what I mean? Like, let them put it on and see that it's maybe uncomfortable. And then if a woman decides that she likes those, because there are other options between granny panty and thong. I mean, we know that. There are a lot of underwears out there. But I really feel, I mean, I don't ever ask permission for to wear a certain type of underwear. I will say, if I'm going out on a date or it's a date night situation, I do wear different underwear, you know?
Right.
Than I normally wear day to day. mostly just because I don't want, because I have underwear that I can wear around the house that falls off.
I got the special pair of underwear that only has one hole in it.
That's right.
Well, I wish I had a catchphrase that made a lot of money. You know, that's what I think I need to work on. Is having something.
I thought your catchphrase was, I am on a tight weekly schedule. That was, I thought we agreed on that.
That's part of it.
Okay.
That's one of them. But yeah. I need one that pays a lot of money because, you know, Owen Wilson has the catchphrase, wow. You know,
is that
in
a
every movie, Owen Wilson. Wow.
Does he do that? I think that's, what's that? Zimbruder effect? Wait, what is the effect? Mandela.
This is a Pruder film effect. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. I don't think he really does that, does he? I think that's just something that people didn't.
Okay. He said it 102 times in every if you combine it in all of his movies.
Oh,
wow. Only about 94 to go.
Wow.
Right. Enough.
How much do you think he makes every time he says wow?
When's the last movie he's actually done? I don't remember. It's been a while, hasn't it? Since he's been in a big film?
When was the last time he was in a movie? I don't know. No, he was in Loki. That was pretty popular, right?
Loki. What was that? The show?
That was that Marvel show that was pretty popular for a while.
Okay, so the first season was good, right? The Loki. And then the second season was kind of like, what? It was too much happening and it was like confusing. And so I kind of stopped watching it. And maybe I watched it, but I just was looking at my phone more. I can tell when I'm not disinterested because I start looking at my phone because for some reason I can't be unentertained for 2 seconds. I got to get on my phone. But I think that's what it was after a while. It's just like, there's just so much going on and it doesn't really get to a point. What is there another scene where a guy's just sitting there chatting between the action scenes? I don't know. But anyway, Loki was not my favorite. I watched that and then I unsubscribed from Disney Plus. So I blame Owen Wilson for that.
Well, he got sucked into that Marvel universe and I miss when he did those comedies with Vince Vaughn. I liked those a lot. And then him and Vince Vaughn broke up.
Did he do more than one? He did Wedding Crasher?
And Wedding then, Crasher.
And then Wedding Crasher 2?
Wedding Crasher 2.
Wedding Crasher 3 in 3D, something. You know, like that?
Two Wedding, Two Crashers.
Oh, what are they? Built an empire. No, but he used to be like in every other movie. Wasn't he in... the movie, Meet the Fockers or the Parents or the one of those. He was the love interest.
Oh, yeah. He was in all the Meet the Parents movie because he was, wasn't he? Yeah, he was. Like he's been in a lot of movies. He was
the boyfriend.
You're right, in every movie for a while, it seemed like.
It was too much. Like he had been overexposed. It was enough. So maybe he's taking a long sabbatical just so he can come back and we can love him again. There's nothing wrong with Owen Wilson. I think he's, does just a fine. But I seem to like his brother even more. Is it his brother?
Luke?
The dark hair. Luke, yeah. I like him.
Yeah.
He's in a lot of stuff that I like. And then
I'm going to go punch up a script right now for Owen.
Oh, good. There you go. Get to work.
I'll be right back. Well, look at that. We did it. We did it all. And I got to all the audio that I wanted to play. And
did you?
So did you. And
are you sure?
You know,
I don't know.
You do
I've got
sometimes.
A lot of audio.
I'll try to set up a clip and then you will derail me. I want you to know that I expect that to happen and I want it to happen because it's fun. So I do enjoy it.
That's the way radio works. The content that I have anytime, occasionally, it will be something that maybe I've produced and I know we have a time constraint and I know how much time we have. And that's the only time when I get worried about derailing too much, but it's a show. Like we have a show every day. I could play it again on the next one with the full clip. You know what I mean? It's like, so I don't really worry about like the other day I had this lion sound. And if we ran out of time for that, I can play that any day. You know, like, it's not.
I mean, that's the thing too, is like anything that I don't get to because we go off on a different tangent, I'll just make a little note and then we'll talk about it another day. So we'll get to everything eventually.
I'm really trying to do you a favor because I know you're on a tight weekly schedule and sometimes your prep time is minimal for the show. So I got to help you stretch it out. If I can. So that's really what I'm doing.
Is it that obvious?
No, that's not what I mean. I didn't mean that. I know. It never sounds like that. No. But
a lot of smoke and mirrors.
I enjoy what you do. I'm not putting you down in any way.
We did a lot though. We talked about you actually brought in some beautiful facts. I like when you bring in these facts and we learn. It's like going inside of the head of a brilliant professor or a scientist. And
oh, yeah.
You learn so much when you bring in your facts. We were talking
about how the head of Lincoln at Mount Rushmore has a room where they store secret documents or important documents. Now, I don't know what those are. Maybe it's just
Meemaw's oatmeal cookie recipe.
I would think maybe it's like the documents of how the Mount Rushmore came to be and maybe some photographs, things like that. I'm sure they have a museum there too.
Maybe, or maybe it's like a whole bunch of mailers from Bed Bath and Beyond.
Yeah, just stuffed into a box. Yeah, it's an overflow for a mailbox that hasn't been checked in years. Like Bed Bath and Beyonce, something like that. Right. Like, whoa, what's going on? And we also, I did a bunch of those. I mean, the thing is about, did you know? Is half the time I'm learning them as I'm saying them on the air. You know, like I'm wow.
I know.
Like for
instance.
It's cool.
It's real-time learning.
Did you know spandex got its name because of its anagram that it expands? It's spandex, I guess. And by the way.
That makes sense. Yeah.
I highly recommend any guy, if you're afraid, if you have to go to an event and you're worried about like maybe you gained a couple of pounds. Get some man spanks.
It's not my job to worry.
Yeah. Get yourself some man spanks. I did. And I don't know what it is. It's like having a hug around your fat ass. And I like
it. I think more people should embrace a nice pair of sweatpants too. Like enough of this jeans. Yeah.
I don't wear any denim. I do have denim jackets, but I don't have any pants anymore. I just wear very comfortable loose-fitting pants that, like, appear to be something they're not. You know, like a pant with a panel on the front that can expand. Because why constrict your veritables? Nobody needs that.
Everybody needs to be comfortable.
And then I wear a spank. And I only wear a spank. And I don't, like, wear a spank to go to the grocery store. But, like, if I'm going to an event or I'm in a meeting where people have to see me, I wear something that compresses down my man beasts, you know? And so people don't look at those teats or they're flopping around into that t-shirt. No, I want it bright and tight without having to do the how many sit-ups do you have to do to get a six pack? Like five? I don't want to do five sit-ups. So I get a spank and that holds it in and everything's tight and right. And when somebody hugs me, they don't feel the flop either. So I'm okay about being pressed up against for a second.
Well, as you should be. It's a good tip. And if anybody would like to pick up the Mood Killers girdle, just head on over to moodkillersradio.com. And there's a little merch button. You can also find our podcast there, moodkillersradio.com. Mood Killers. They have
to. Do you think we spend a lot more time than we should worrying about the people that work in restaurants